The circumpacific region is defined by subduction zone plate boundaries that produce 80% of the earthquakes worldwide. It also has over 400 active volcanoes, earning it the title, the Pacific Ring of Fire. More than one quarter of the world's great magnitude 8 or larger earthquakes have occurred in western South America. It's home to the 1960 magnitude 9.5 Chile megathrust earthquake, the largest earthquake ever recorded, as well as to an array of earthquakes generated by plate boundary and intraplate tectonic processes. Regional tectonics are dominated by the subduction of the oceanic Nazca plate beneath the continental South American plate, which produced both the 5,900-kilometer-long Peru-Chile trench that extends from Colombia to southern Chile, and the arc of active volcanoes parallel to the trench. Rates of convergence range from 5.6 centimeters a year in Ecuador to 6.3 centimeters a year in northern Chile. They've recently been updated using GPS observations. South America has over 800 measured earthquakes every year. By examining all earthquakes greater than magnitude 5 over a 10-year period, we see a pattern of shallow to deep earthquakes from west to east across the subduction zone. A cross-section through central Chile shows how earthquakes outline classic subduction geometry. To 70 kilometers depth, earthquakes are concentrated along the plate boundary, but also occur within both plates near that boundary. Below 70 kilometers, earthquakes occur only within the relatively cold and therefore brittle subducting plate. Andean volcanoes are located above the point where the top of the Nazca plate has subducted to about 150 kilometers depth, which is about 300 kilometers from the trench. The melting of mantle rocks just above the subducting plate, not the melting of the subducting plate itself, generates the magma that supplies these volcanoes. In Ecuador and southern Chile, the pattern of earthquakes is similar, with the oceanic plate diving at an angle of about 30 degrees and volcanoes located 300 to 400 kilometers from the trench. However, in most of Peru, and at about 30 degrees south in Chile, where the volcanoes are absent, earthquakes reveal what is called flat slab subduction. In these segments, the oceanic plate dives to 100 kilometers depth and then slides along the bottom of the South American plate for several hundred kilometers before resuming its descent into Earth's mantle. There are no active volcanoes above the flat slab subduction. Flat slab regions occur where unusually thick and therefore buoyant oceanic crust caps the Nazca plate, like along the Nazca and Juan Fernandez ridges. Since 1906, there have been 16 great earthquakes of magnitude 8 or larger on the megathrust boundary between the Nazca and South American plates. Yellow patches indicate the area ruptured in each great earthquake. Gaps between ruptures, called seismic gaps, are particularly vulnerable to future earthquakes because potential energy continues to build between the locked plates. The region in northernmost Chile was designated the Iquique seismic gap because it had not had a great earthquake since 1877. On April 1, 2014, a magnitude 8.2 earthquake confirmed the forecast, releasing energy in a portion of the seismic gap. Aside from this gap, the Ecuador-Peru seismic gap is also conspicuous. To explore the mechanics of subduction zone megathrust earthquakes, let's examine the 1960 magnitude 9.5 Chile earthquake, the largest instrumentally recorded seismic event. For great earthquakes, the displacement at the hypocenter is just the beginning. The initial fault break in 1960 triggered a runaway rupture that displaced an area more than 800 kilometers long. The entire fault rupture happened over the course of 4 minutes, releasing immense seismic energy equivalent to a cascade of 10,000 magnitude 7 earthquakes. Still, most of the damage was caused by the resulting tsunami, which we can examine by looking at a cross-section. The oceanic Nazca plate dives beneath the more buoyant continental plate. Because tectonic plates are elastic, like a spring, the leading edge of the continental plate stores elastic energy as the plates converge. With the megathrust plate boundary locked by friction, the upper plate is forced back and shortened, raising the land surface while depressing the ocean floor between the coast and the trench. In 1960, the force of the converging plates overcame friction, causing the leading edge of the continental plate to lurch seaward. During the earthquake, uplift of the seafloor formed a mound of seawater that spread out as a tsunami, while coastal and nearby inland areas dropped down. 5.8 meters of uplift was measured on several offshore islands, while subsidence of as much as 2.3 meters affected land areas near the coast. The resulting tsunami reached heights of 15 meters along the outer coast, causing over 1,000 of the 1,425 fatalities in Chile. The Trans-Pacific tsunami was one of the most destructive in modern times, killing 61 in Hawaii, 32 in the Philippines, and 142 in Japan. The 1960 tsunami motivated development of the International Pacific Tsunami Warning System. Although the largest earthquakes affecting South America are subduction zone megathrust events, earthquakes within rather than between the plates have caused the most fatalities in recent history. For example, the magnitude 7.9 Chimbote, Peru earthquake in 1970 was the most deadly earthquake in the Americas. Fault motion that produced this earthquake occurred within the upper brittle part of the subducting Nazca plate. Although the magnitude 9.5 Chile earthquake released over 300 times as much energy, the location of the Peru earthquake at 54 kilometers depth below the port city of Chimbote and a massive earthquake-induced landslide caused great loss of life. 100 million cubic meters of rock and glacial ice broke from Nevado Huascarán, the highest mountain in the Peruvian Andes. The resulting debris avalanche rushed down a glacial valley at speeds of up to 300 kilometers per hour, burying towns in rock, ice, and mud up to 30 meters deep. The death toll was estimated at 70,000. In 1944, the most deadly earthquake in Argentinian history destroyed much of San Juan, killing 8,000 people beneath collapsed buildings. How did the Nazca-South American plate interactions produce this magnitude 7.0 earthquake within the South American crust, almost 400 kilometers east of the trench? The Sierras Pampeanas region of northwestern Argentina is within a flat slab subduction of the Nazca-South American subduction zone. The cross-section through this region shows earthquakes in two depth intervals, within the brittle crusts of both the South American plate and the underlying Nazca plate. As the oceanic plate rubs horizontally along the base of the continental plate, compressive forces build in the continental crust. These forces eventually break the continental crust into blocks separated by thrust faults. The magnitude 7.0 earthquake occurred on one of these thrust faults, rupturing from 20 kilometers depth up to the surface near San Juan, demonstrating that intense ground shaking from a nearby magnitude 7 earthquake can be more destructive than a larger earthquake at a greater distance. Western South America is a region of high earthquake hazard because of tsunami-generating megathrust earthquakes on the Nazca-South American plate boundary, major earthquakes within the subducting plate beneath populated coastal towns, and major earthquakes on faults within the continental crust. Earthquake and tsunami education, along with the construction of earthquake-resilient buildings and infrastructure, have proved to be vitally important to this seismically active region.